welcome Brian Ferry.
Hello. How are you? Good to see you.
Thank you.
Hello.
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 It's wonderful to have you on the show.
Well, very nice to be here.
Let me introduce. This is Caitlin.
Hello, pleased to meet you, darling.
I know you know Boris.
We are old friends. Yes.
And this is
and Felix.
Felix.
I met briefly.
Did you watch from the show? From...
Yes, I did. Yeah. Very entertaining. You've all been.
you know we've been talking about it.
Well, I know. Yes. I was blushing. You know?
Did you know about the Melody Maker? What they said about you?
I was also born very poor, and I used to deliver the Melody Maker to make money every week. I used to read it, you know, voraciously every Friday, I think it was. I used to deliver the papers, and on Friday was the Melody Maker day, and I would walk down the street reading every copy of it, and the NME and all the other papers as well. So the Melody Maker was a big part of my formative years, yeah.
Oh, well, maybe this is why they would never slag you off then. They just knew that you delivered it. It was out of loyalty. It was like some kind of deal.
Also, they wrote the first interview with me, and I remember sending a tape to Richard Williams, who was the editor in those days, and I thought, if anybody's going to like my music, it's going to be him, because I like what he wrote. You know? And sure enough, he rang me and said, I love this record, and so it all started from there, really.
They say about you... That you're a shy man.
Yeah, I was always born. From growing up, I was always very shy, very reserved, you know. And getting into music was a strange choice in a way, because I play every night to audiences of people.
So, in what situations are you shy?
Situations like this, where I have no control.
You have no reason to be shy. You have this fantastic songbook. We all have memories with your songs. You know, Boris was telling about his very vivid memory of
I'm deeply honored,
using your song to get rid of a girl.
They twist your words. No, that was very nice. Mm.
You come from, as you mentioned, your background. It's from North England.
Yeah, northeast. Yeah.
Yeah, a mining town.
County Durham. Yeah, and actually, it's a strange place because it's on the one hand very industrial, but lots of farming there as well. So, my dad was a farmer when he grew up. Worked on a farm as a ploughman actually. So he used to have four horses. Pulling the plough, and he'd walk along. You know. Rather kind of 19th century sort of job, really. And my mother was from the town, so they were a great combination of my dad being very reserved, very quiet, very country, and my mother very vivacious and always talking, and polyferia. She had lots of friends, and it was interesting.
Did you ever, as Caitlin mentioned, did you ever reinvent yourself?
Oh, yeah, I guess so. I mean, the thing is, as soon as I started reading about art and reading poetry that I liked and stuff, when I was, I guess, I don't know, 14, 15, I gravitated towards those subjects. So I loved English. I loved history as well, actually, and art. Those are the three things that I loved. And I chose art. That's what I wanted to do, to be a painter. And the more I kind of learned about the world out there, the more I became a different person, I guess, from how I was when I was just a kid, you know. I went to university when I was about 17 and met people like myself who came from all over the world, really, but who wanted to be artists. And... that was when my life really sort of started to change.
You're still, I know, describe yourself as a workaholic. You work a lot.
Yeah, I like to work. It's what I do. Yeah, it's.
And you work.
I try to have a bit of fun. otherwise, life would be boring. But I tour a lot. I travel a lot, and that's very good for the mind, I think.
Being so much on tour as you've been. Uh-huh. Working so much, as it. What have you sacrificed?
a certain amount of normalcy in my life, I guess. I think I'm pretty philosophical about it now, that you can't have everything. And what life gives, sometimes it takes away, you know, and the tide comes in and goes out. You know. There's a lot of balance in nature. And,
what didn't you have?
I think, well, I don't have... I'm not married. I mean, I've had two divorces, so I mean, that's a couple of things that went wrong. And it didn't work out, say, in my life, but...
Well, you're not alone in this company, so it's...
I've had so far, it's still kind of, hopefully, a long way to go, a very exciting career, and I've enjoyed... I love making records. And now I do a lot of live shows as well. So.
And you're a perfectionist. I know from rehearsals here.
I try to get it right. Yeah.
From the time you use in studio, you spend a lot of time in studio.
Yeah. You try to perfect things. You try and do things as well as you can. I think we'd all agree that, you know, we all try to do what we do to the best of our abilities.
Have you ever heard him live? No. He is so good. And honestly, now nowadays musicians, I find, they're very good on the computer. Very few can actually go on stage and sing and perform. Gotta see this man live. He's really, really exceptional.
Well, we are in the minute, you know.
Yeah.
Here in London. Yeah. whenever I read about you, your style is always commented because you've always been an aesthetic and a very visual person. With your album covers, mm-hmm. and everything, as a former artist, and painter, but also the way you dress, it's always commented.
Well, I had two jobs when I was at school: one delivering papers, and then I'd rush home and put a suit on. And then go into Newcastle, where I worked in the tailor shop every Saturday until about 5, and I'd run home and deliver the football papers. And so I worked in a tailor shop when I was young as well. I like wearing suits, yeah.
Yeah, old-fashioned, really. Do you care a lot about fashion, or is it just something...
No, I'm more interested in fabrics and tailoring than fashion, per se. So and men's clothes don't really change that much. I mean... over the years, it's all about little details, really.
Do you ever wear a sweaty pair of jogging bottoms and just an old T-shirt?
Oh, if I go to the gym, yes.
Yes. Or in the studio, do you come in fully dressed in the studio,
I serious work. Come on, man.
Yeah, no.
I wear a tie in the studio, believe it or not. Yeah, but I like wearing suits.
Elegant. Yeah. You're so classy.
When I was a kid, watching all these great jazz players and so on, they always wore suits and looked cool and smart. And I remember people like Duke Ellington, you know, and they'd say, like, well, you know, it's important that you look your best when you go on stage. And that kind of had a spin-off.
Well, it's often a working-class thing as well, isn't it? Just kind of, you know,
look
sharp. Just look sharp, look
out. Yeah, my mother would have been embarrassed if I hadn't done
it. He's a style icon to you as well.
Yeah, very much.
And I was actually quite surprised that you
were
so...
you actually were a suit.
No, I know, that sounded rude. It wasn't rude. It wasn't meant rude, because in your videos on YouTube...
You have a point, yeah.
You don't dress up for that.
I mean...
Not that much.
The thing is, I only film my face, pretty much.
Yeah,
so I don't even have to wear pants. It's great. I just sit in my...
Okay.
But, I mean, of course I have to.
But you wear pants. Not always. Brian, the song you're going to do for us is called Loop the Lie.
Loop the Lie, yeah.
What is that?
Oh, it's taken from a children's nursery rhyme, Loop de Loop, Loop de Lie, and it's people dancing in a circle. And it's like it's a song about sort of emotional conflict.
It's a breakup song.
It's kind of, I mean, a lot of the best songs are written...
Don't look at me, I'm happily married at the moment. I mean,
a lot of the best songs are written about sad things in life, I think. And I was always attracted myself to sad music. And music that had passion, you know, and made me feel something. And so not many of my songs are happy ones, but One or two, like Virginia Plain and stuff like that.
Why do you think that? Are you sad as a person?
I was just attracted to the melancholy side of music, and I think some of the I like deep emotion in songs.
We're going to listen to that now.
Okay.
Thank you so much. A big hand for PewDiePie.